here on Indie Style, we'll feature successful entrepreneurs from across the globe who are making incredible strides in their industry. You may not know their names yet, but you soon will. I'm Leah DeVon, and this is Indie Style.
Leah, what's going on?
Hello and welcome to Indie Style. I am your host, Leah DeVon. Well, I'm really excited about my show today because today we are virtually traveling to England and we get to meet a very special guest. Her name is Bibi Shadbolt. And she is a filmmaker. And I tell you, she has written an incredible feature film. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about her career. And welcome to the show, Bibi Shadbolt.
Thank you. Thank you, Leah. Thanks for having me.
Hi. Wait.
Thank you.
How are you doing today?
I'm very good. I'm very, very good. And I'm so happy to be here.
Well, we are excited, and I'm so thrilled because, you know, Bibi, I learned about your success and everything that you were doing actually over a year ago from an incredible publicist, marketing gentleman that is over in London, and he said, I have something really special, and when we have the opportunity, I want you to talk to Bibi, so I'm so grateful that I have this opportunity. So welcome to Indie Style.
Thank you for having me here. It's such a privilege to be here.
Oh, it's a privilege to have you on the show. So let's kind of like, let's go back a little bit and kind of talk a little bit about your backstory. You know, how did you become a filmmaker? Did you go to school to learn your craft?
No, I would say it was more or less accidental, actually. I did actually study creative writing as part of my degree back home in Ghana. So I did English literature, creative writing, and I also did child education. So when I finished university, I started as a teacher. And as a teacher, I was writing scripts for the children to act, you know, so it was more like stage drama for the children to act during Christmas celebration. But when I came here, I diverted to a different career altogether. So I went into marketing, sales, and finance. But I continued to write, and my church community had a TV station. And they had this TV show, which was like about two girls, like a, what is it called? A sitcom. So they said, oh, we need someone to just write one episode. And I was like, oh, okay, let me just write something for them. And when the producer read it, she was like, gosh, you are a screenwriter. You got, you know, it was so lighthearted. It had comedy in it. And she was like, no, you have to take that as a career. So yeah, I went to, I didn't really go to film school, but I went to a school here called Rain Dance. So they are short courses. So I first did a course in screenwriting. And then I was like, yeah, why don't I get into directing and producing? So I did courses in that as well. So yeah, that is briefly my story.
Okay, that's a really good story, by the way. That's incredible. It kind of seems to me that you just have a gift for writing, because I know so many people go to film school and they intern and they do so many things. So that's like your gift. So that is wonderful. I want to talk a little bit about what has brought us together. You wrote and directed a feature film called Afua's Diary. Yeah. And it is so good, Bibi. Congratulations on
thank
that.
You, thank you. Thank you.
Explain to our audience what a feature film is.
Okay, so a feature film is any film that is longer than 70 minutes. So yeah, basically that. So once it's, yeah. So FY's Diary is a, it's an hour and 30 minutes film. So that is what we classify it as, yeah, a feature film.
Okay. And this is critically acclaimed feature film. A lot of awards, lot of recognition. How did the film come into fruition? And tell us a little bit about some of the awards and recognition.
Okay, so the film is really, when I finished doing my course, I wanted to do a film, and I've always liked love stories. So I said, yeah, I just want to write a love story. But when I did my research, not many people want the boy meet girl, they fall in love, they fall out, and they, you know, so there has to be more of a backstory to it. So I said, okay, what can I use as a backstory? And the best way to write it, to, you know, to write or create a film is to first do something that resonates with you. So FY's Diary follows the life of a Ghanaian marketing graduate in the UK who is going through challenges with immigration and, you know, her father back home and her relationship. And it's something that I am a Ghanaian immigrant in the UK. So it's something that even if I haven't experienced some of the things FY experiences in the film, there are so many people around me who have experienced one thing or the other. But actually, the story itself was inspired by a true story. So, So the lead character, Alan, you know, he is an English guy. I mean, we changed it to an Italian guy just to twist the story a little bit. But he is an English guy who married an African lady. And then after they got married, the girl left him. And so everybody said, oh, she married you because of the papers. So after that, he met another girl. And he was a bit, there was an issue with trust. So I said, let me build my story around there. So I decided to write a FY's Diary, put comedy into it. And I'm very happy with the reception it had. So the first, after we finished the film, what we did was premiere it here in London. And we had a lot of good reviews. So I was like, why don't I enter it into festivals? So there was this festival in Cannes, Pan-African Film Festival. We took it there and it was selected as one of the best. So we had to do encore and they had to...
Congratulations.
Thank you. And then after that, I had an award for, I mean, it was a small award in New York, but it was for Women of Film Descent, African Descent Film Festival. So I won that. And then we were nominated for the film, Screen Nation Film Festival here, which they call the Black BAFTAs. So it's more like the Black Oscars here in the UK. And we did. It really went way better than we thought. And I'm very grateful for that.
That's like a lot of accolades. You should be so, I'm proud of you. Just as a woman, I'm celebrating your success on all of the wonderful awards and all of the recognition, because the film is wonderful. And guys, it's streaming and available on Roku right now. So I want you to definitely check out her film and her feature film and see what the rave is about. I saw it and it was wonderful. And it still kind of blows me away that this is not what you've done full time as your career. You're really, really talented.
Thank you.
How did you cast? How did you get these actors and actresses to be a part of your film?
Yeah, I think we were very lucky. So me and my co-director. So to start with, I partnered with a production company, Pixless Aspect. And my co-director, Ben, and my co-producers, well, the first thing we did was to cast the FY's dad, who is a well-established, I mean, established actor in Ghana. He holds the number one talk show in Ghana. So everybody know, I mean, you mentioned his name. His name is KSM. So anybody who has initials as their name, you know that they are very popular. So yeah, he's very, very popular in Ghana. We cast him first, yes. And we were very happy that, you know, we just sent him a random email and he said, sent me the script. He read the script and was like, wow, I love it. I will be on board. So after we cast him, we just had went on to a casting platform. So the leads, the supporting acts were all cast from the casting platform. But we were very lucky that all of them came together, and it was like they worked together before. We just worked together as a family. So it was amazing. Wow. Thank you.
I had a chance to Wikipedia everybody, and I was following everybody on Instagram and Facebook if they're on. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You know, sometimes actors that are established will jump on a project because they believe in it, and sometimes they're like, I'm not.
Exactly. So
that was a really wonderful thing. You know, did you have any challenges when you were filming your film, or was it smooth sailing?
Gosh, I have to write a book on this, to be honest. The challenges, gosh. You know, there were so many challenges to start with. First of all, I mean, it sounds like a myth or, you know, cliche, but being a woman in the film industry is tough. It's really, really challenging for people to just believe in you that you can actually do it. It was very tough. So I had to write letters, you know, look for people who will support me. So I was very lucky when, you know, Pixless Aspect, they decided to come on board. And secondly, you know, the whole issue of promoting African genre, a film that deals with Africa, has an African story. People don't really, it's not something that is common. So it's just like, you know, flogging something that is, you know, quite new to people. So it was also challenging. But in terms of the filming itself and getting the actors to come on set and everything, everybody was so cooperative. So it was very, very good in that respect.
Well, let's share a little sneak peek of the trailer of A Fool's Diary. Okay?
Hi, Dad.
But I just sent you $500 a day.
Yes, the money is in the bank.
And you can't go for it because
I'm in the hospital.
This one goes out to you and yours. You see, this is what I hate about you. You deliberately do this. And then later you want to apologize for it, huh?
Are you out of your mind? You know how the Easter come up in 2005?
Oh, I hate my job.
And unfortunately, the letter says you have no right of appeal.
What does that mean?
It means you've got no right of appeal.
Oh, the hunky Italian guy.
Him, it was him. He started a new company and he wants me to be the sales and marketing manager. It sounds brilliant.
It really sounds brilliant.
He's so smitten by your looks, he forgot what to call.
I don't think he fancies me.
Of course he does.
He asked me out.
What?
Do you promise to love each other exclusively and divinely till death do you part?
Percy?
Well, you put me on the spot.
Can't go back to
I don't know what to say.
It's not what you think.
But I'm trying anyway. Like my heart's gonna drop, my mind drifts away, and I can't control the pain. Words are spinning in my head, don't know why I'm holding back. I should just tell you how I'm feeling, yeah. But I don't wanna act a fool, don't wanna look confused. If I let you know about the way I feel, don't know what you're gonna do. So I keep it locked inside and imagine you were mine.
I love a Bibi Shadbolt.
Thank you.
That is wonderful. So let me, you know, our audience, you know, you guys, you have to check out this film. It's incredible. If you could give some tips of success to our viewers, what are some tips that you would, you know, to somebody trying to do what you're doing? Let's give them a tip.
The first thing I'll say is passion. You know, you have to have that passion. You have to ask yourself, is it something you really want to do? Is it something I would do even if I'm not getting paid for? And that is what should tell you that this is where you've been, you know, what you've been called to do. And I'm not going to sit down and say, oh, it's a walk in the park. You can just do it, just do it. It is hard work. You will get rejected. You will get, you know, it's hard work, but hard work always pays, and passion is what will take you to the top. So follow your passion and you get there.
Well, I love it. And you guys, it is Bibi's anniversary today. So we're so excited. Yes. So happy anniversary, and thank you for sharing your time with us today. And
thank you.
Here at Indie Style TV, we celebrate successful entrepreneurs that are just like you, and we are so honored to have you on the show. And
thank you.
Are you working on any projects?
Yes, I'm working on a project now, and I've got very popular African American actors in it who have already signed to attach. So I'm not going to mention it. it's a briefly, I'll just take 1 minute to say that it's a film set in Nigeria and UK, and the main idea for me doing this film is to show the beautiful side of Africa that we don't see on TV. So it's a love story about an arrogant fashion executive who goes to Africa, reluctantly goes to Africa to work, and then she meets a taxi driver who makes her see the other side of life. Beautiful story. It's been very challenging getting it going, but we're going to start filming before the end of the year.
Oh, well, congratulations. And thank you again so much for coming on the show today. And guys, I hope that you have enjoyed Bibi. And is there any place we can find you if we wanted to find you on social media? Where could we find you?
So my Twitter handle is at @BibiShadbolt. And then on Facebook, I've got two Facebook fan pages. One is Bibi Owusu-Shadbolt Films, and one is Boss Films, which is BOS Films. And also my website is www.bossfilms.co.uk.
Awesome. Okay. So listen, guys, I hope that you have enjoyed my interview today with the incredibly talented filmmaker, producer, writer, Bibi Shadbolt. So I'm gonna let you go and enjoy the rest of your anniversary. And thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. Can I just say a big thank you to Tungai Arnold for just setting this for me. And he's just an amazing manager, an amazing publicist, opening so many doors to me. So I just want to say thank you to him and my business partner, Alan Redding, and my husband. Thank you.
I love that you did that. Many thank people you. Don't, but I love that you did. It shows the beauty right here. So I'm excited for all the wonderful things that are going to continue your way. So thank you again for joining us on the show. And thank I want you to enjoy the rest of your day. Okay, Bibi?
Thank you, Leah. Thank you so much for having me. I've really enjoyed it. Thank you.
Wonderful. And I wish you continued success. I know only wonderful things are going to continue to come your way. So guys, I hope that you have enjoyed this edition of Indie Style. And I tell you, I'm inspired. Or inspired. You should be very inspired. And until next time, I am Leah DeVon. Be well.
So good. Ain't rockin' fugazi, so don't try to play me. You know that you really ain't topping this. I need me some shade, we gon' block out the haters. New food routines need to be copping this. I can't check, let me go flex. I know you can't see, but I'm probably lit. They took me for granted, I went independent. Now they wanna come and try rock with it. I wear my S's when I'm hitting Lennox. Might get a platter from Papa Do's. I wear my shades when I'm up in the studio. Made a few hits, I might drop them both. Warn a tip, they love the first verse. They wanted a second, I got them both. I can't check, now I can flex. The Lex on my face, cause my eyes are low. Same game, different day, spit it. Same name, different style, lenses. New color, way about to drop. These frames got my fit fitted.